Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and hope you're all doing great. Today we have two important updates to share with you. First, we'll talk about updates regarding SpaceX's progress on the first orbital Starship launch. Then we'll briefly discuss about SpaceX's upcoming launch mission, Inspiration 4. So without further delay, let's begin our update, which is about SpaceX's Starship S20. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk's tweet from the 15th of August states, "First orbital stack of Starship should be ready for flight in a few weeks, pending only regulatory approval." This indicates the sooner launching of SpaceX's Starship into the orbit. Starship was stacked to its full height on August 6th, leading to the largest rocket assembled ever. The company installed Raptor engines in Super Heavy Booster 4 and Starship 20. However, even after all these, neither of them were absolutely ready, and their engines had yet to qualify through the test campus. They needed some extra works of wiring. Partially completed, Starship S20 was moved to SpaceX's Boca Chica launch site on August 13th for completion and is still there. On August 11th, SpaceX removed the Super Heavy Booster 4 from the orbital launch mount and returned it to the build site. Both S20 and Booster 4 got their Raptors removed after their returns, allowing teams to complete cryogenic proof testing. The tests will include working with chemicals like supercooled liquid nitrogen, liquid oxygen, and methane. SpaceX gradually equipped one of the two suborbital launch mounts with hydraulic rams. These will simulate the thrust of Starship 20's sea-level and vacuum-optimized Raptor engines. For Booster 4, SpaceX has equipped a test jig with 9 hydraulic rams to simulate the thrust of 9 engines pushing. An extra tool, referred to as Can Crusher, suggested that B4 would be subject to enormous simulated thrusts of 29 Raptor engines. However, later, SpaceX removed the hydraulic rams, S20 was sent beside the orbital launch mount. These events suggested that probably SpaceX canceled the cryo-proofing plans. Till date, every major design change carried out on Starship's engines have led to cryo-proof testing with complex series of hydraulic rams on one or more tanks. But Super Heavy's 9-engine thrust puck have never been subjected to such tests so far. The assembling and disassembling removal of the test stands clearly suggests that someone at SpaceX, probably Musk himself, has decided that the tests are not worth the time and is ready to skip them. Also, with Musk's tweet about Ship 20 and Booster 4 being ready within a few weeks, it's clear that these few days are not enough to cryo-proof, thrust sim, and static fire both vehicles. However, speaking technically, 14 to 20 days is not enough for Starship to be ready for launching unless some legal intervention takes place. Now, moving on to our next update, which is about SpaceX's upcoming launch mission, Inspiration 4. SpaceX is on the verge of creating history on the 15th of September 2021 with the launch of the world's first all-civilian spaceflight, Inspiration 4. As we know, the mission is funded by Jarek Isaacman, founder and CEO of Shift 4 Payments. The billionaire entrepreneur will lead the crew with 3 other crew members. All the 4 members will be termed as astronauts after the launch of the mission. Inspiration 4 is about to become the first spaceflight to travel without professional astronauts. All the members have put rigorous efforts into the training events to get prepared for the launch and are extremely excited for the day. Other than Isaacman, the other crew members are Haley Arsenault, Shan Proctor, and Chris Zembrowski. They've been chosen by their relation to St. Jude's Children's Hospital. Moreover, the motto of the flight is to raise awareness and funding for the hospital. Haley is St. Jude's physician assistant and childhood bone cancer survivor from Louisiana. Chris Zembrowski is a data engineer, geoscientist, and science communicator from North Carolina, whereas Shan Proctor is an artist and has also been a professor in Arizona. Referring to the misfortunate families in the St. Jude Hospital, Isaacman remarked, "You really don't get to a position that I'm fortunate enough to be in without the ball bouncing your way a couple of times." He also added, "These families at St. Jude were dealt horrible hands. They're going through what no one should ever have to go through. It's immense heartache, and the sad part is many of those kids will not grow up to have any of the experiences that I've been lucky enough to have in life. We've just got to do something about that." The crew, which has been under training, is certainly excited. "I could not be more excited," crew member Haley Arsenault explained in a recent interview. Describing the training, she said, "A lot of it's been academics and studying on our own." She also added, "Really learning the nominal overview of the mission and the ins and outs of our spacecraft. And on top of that, we've done the typical astronaut training with centrifuge training, we're going to do some water survival training, and the hyperbaric chamber. Of course, experiencing the zero-G environment and floating and in that moment where I see Earth from space for the first time. But what I'm truly looking forward to the most is we're going to call the St. Jude's patients from space," she remarked. She now works as an assistant in St. Jude, but as a child was a patient herself there. She's now a cancer survivor and soon going to create history. She mentioned, "It's going to be so fun for our kids to see somebody who's in their same shoes getting to grow and accomplish their dreams and then knowing that they can do the same. All I've ever wanted to do since I was 10 is work at St. Jude, and so I never thought I'd be an astronaut. Until now, astronauts have really had to be physically perfect, and I don't fall into that category. I've a metal rod in my leg from where they saved my leg. I just feel so honored to be paving the way." The rest of the crew is equally eager to experience their first flight and return with all their amazing stories. According to the plan, the crew will launch into orbit on the top of a Falcon 9 rocket and orbit the Earth for 3 days and then return. The crew also got the opportunity to train with a fighter jet. Crew member Proctor said in an interview, "It's something you dream of your entire life." Proctor tweeted, "By far one of the best parts of the mission's training is flying, and even though our rocket will be going way faster, this gives us an opportunity to gain situational awareness in a complex, fast-moving fighter jet." Sembrowski, on the other hand, was not supposed to be part of the flying crew. He joined as a part of the mission's non-profit fundraising campaign. There was a lucky contest for a seat on the flight. The one who originally won the seat passed it to Sembrowski, who thus now happens to be a part of Inspiration 4. "It feels just so overwhelmingly satisfying and amazing. I feel so blessed that there was so much generosity afforded to me to make this all happen," Sembrowski told in a separate interview. "The realization really hit me when I opened up the mission gift bag and pulled out the mission patch and just kind of held it in my hands for a few minutes. And having that in your hand and just feeling that and seeing that you make that physical connection to the story that you just saw play out on the computer screen. So far, everything's set for the launch. The Inspiration 4 crew will take off aboard a SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule on top of a Falcon 9 rocket from 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. In addition, the launch will be documented as a series on Netflix. Along with the training, the members are also assigned with their call signs. Isaac is Rook, Haley is Nova, Proctor is Leo, and Sembrowski is named Hanks. The launch will be recorded for a Netflix series, and Inspiration 4 will be in space in less than even a month. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.